In the final part of the Smoke Getting Started experience, we will backup the project for archival purposes. Creating a project backup backs up everything, including your sequences, setups, and media. Please ensure that you have ample disk space before attempting any archiving. Autodesk Smoke backs up everything into an uncompressed format to ensure the maximum quality is preserved. So here is a housekeeping tip before you archive. Please delete anything you don't want before creating the archive. This will help save on space and time. Now, project archiving is managed within Smoke. This is done through the Media Hub. Switch the file browser to archive mode. The browser will now only display archive-related files. The menus at the bottom of the screen have also updated. The archive buttons are grayed out until you start searching through your devices to go to a designated folder. So navigate to a location for the archive. Find a folder that has read and write permissions. But please do not use your system disk as an archive location. Archive files can easily become massive and eat up all your disk space in a short period of time. Always use a drive dedicated for backups and archives. Once in the right location, click New Archive to bring up the archive creation window. The name of the archive defaults to the name of your project, but you can change this to whatever you want. You also have an editable comments text box, which puts the archive creation date by default. At this point, it is recommended to set a file size limit. This means that the archive will comprise of multiple small files as opposed to one massive file. For example, consider a 50 gigabyte project. If you do not limit the file size, Smoke will generate one archive file that is 50 gigabytes. That is a very large amount of data to deal with in a single file. By limiting the file size, Smoke creates multiple files totaling up to 50 gigabytes. So using 1 gigabyte per file, Smoke will create 51 gigabyte files to back up the 50 gigabyte project. This also makes it easier to split the archive across different storage formats. For example, Smoke creates the archive files and you burn them to DVD using a DVD burning application. Please choose the file size that best fits your infrastructure. Click Create. When you create a new archive, it is empty and nothing is displayed in the view. A tab menu with the archive name tells you the current archive size. Obviously, it's zero at the moment. The other tab is the archive options that are equally important. The default setting is that Smoke will backup everything in the project. So caching the media as well as including the renders will create a total backup of what you have in the project. This is the most complete archive you can get. Even without the original native media, you only need the archive. It will restore just as it was, but everything will be a cached intermediate. If you don't want the renders, just change the option to exclude them. This means that when you restore the project, you will just have to re-render everything. If you disable the cache on archive option, you'll get more choices to optimize the archive. Include renders and cache is the same as before. This is your complete backup. You can archive everything except the renders. You can exclude any cache source media and just archive the renders. Or finally, you could exclude any cached media and renders. Smoke will remember the original file paths to the native media, but all the caches will be lost. With the last two options, it is your responsibility to backup your native media. And if you want Smoke to automatically reconnect to the native files, you will need to recreate the same folder structure for your native media. Let's create a complete archive for this project. So ensure Cache on Archive and Include Renders is enabled. Click Archive Project. Smoke thinks for a bit and presents a pop-up window with an estimated archive size. You can cancel at this point, or confirm to initiate the archive. As Smoke archives, You can monitor the progress at the bottom of the interface. When the archiving completes, a session folder will be stored in the archive. Expanding this out reveals the project and all its contents. Finally, click Close Archive to return to the file system. The archive is represented in a folder list by a small safe icon. Your project archive is now complete. Now let's look at how to restore the project archive. Setting the context, perhaps you have to revisit the old project. With a complete smoke project archive, you should be able to restore the project to its entirety. Switch to the Finder for a moment. This folder contains all the archive files created by Smoke when the project was originally backed up. It is important to note that all archive files need to be in the same folder. If you had backed them up to separate mediums, such as DVDs for example, then you will have to copy them all to the same location. There is another consideration when restoring a project in Smoke. There must not be an existing project with the same name. In the Projects and User settings, I have other projects I have been working on. You can use any of these projects or even a dummy project to restore an old project into Smoke. During the project restore, Smoke will recreate the project and unload all the archive contents into the newly created project. Remembering these two points should make project restoring a much easier process. In order to access the Media Hub, you need to be in an existing Smoke project. Switch to the Archives mode and navigate to the folder containing the archive files. In the file browser, all you will see is one archive file in the folder list. Just select it and press Open Archive. When the archive opens, you can see all the archive's details. To restore the project, expand the Archive Session folder. Select the Smoke project and click the Restore Project button. Smoke begins the restore process and you can monitor it at the bottom of the interface. Once the archive restoration is complete, you can close the archive. Let's just check that the archive has restored correctly. Click the File menu and choose Project and User Settings. Switch to the restored project and press Load. Once the load process is complete, close the Projects and User Settings window. Having a look, you can see in this project, it has restored exactly how it was in the original before it was archived. This concludes your Autodesk Smoke Getting Started experience. To further your learning, please visit the other videos on the Smoke Learning channel. We hope you've enjoyed using Autodesk Smoke. If you have any questions or feedback, please post them on the comments or the Autodesk Area Smoke Forum. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.